Good morning, children. In the last session, we were talking about the Newton's second law of motion and its formulas derived. And then, finally, the units of force was also discussed. There are two units for force, CGS unit and SI unit. In SI system, the unit is Newton. In CGS system, in CGS system, the unit is dyne. And the relation between Newton and dyne. Newton force, 1 Newton force equal to 10 power 5 dyne force. This was also discussed in the last video, in the last class, in the last session. Now we continue further. Related to that Newton's second law of motion. In the Newton's second law of motion, the basic relation is F equal to delta P over delta T. That is, the rate of change in momentum of a body is equal to the force applied in its direction. And from this relation, we obtained that F equal to M into A. That the force applied on any object is equal to the product of mass and the acceleration produced in it. Now, from this relation, we are going to obtain one more quantity by taking the cross multiplication delta P equal to F into delta T. So this F into delta T, F multiplied by delta T, that the force applied on an object in the short interval of time. Suppose any object is placed on a horizontal surface. On this object, a force is applied. And the force is applied on this object for how much time? The interval of time for which the force is applied. That we call that the change in time. For how much time the force is applied. And that time for which the force is applied is also known as time of impact. It is also known as time of impact. Time of impact means for how much time, for how long the force is applied. And for that, how much impact is produced by that force. So, that force multiplied by the interval of time, the given interval of time, that is known as what? Impulse. It is known as impulse. So, we can say impulse is what actually? It is the force multiplied by the short interval of time. That is F into delta T. That is the impulse. What impulse gives? Impulse, it gives the effect of force. Impulse gives effect of force. Means how much effect is produced by the force. Suppose on that object placed on the surface. If we apply the force from any direction, suppose the force is applied from this direction, from the vertically downward direction. Now that force, if it is F, so this force is applied on this object for some interval of time with that force, and for that time interval, how much effect is produced on this object? That the effect of force produced is known as impulse. So impulse is equal to mathematically force multiplied by time interval. From this we can obtain the SI unit of impulse also. So SI unit of impulse is, for force it is Newton, and for time it is second. So it is Newton second is the SI unit of impulse. But the force multiplied by time, the product of force and the time interval, is also equal to change in momentum. So impulse is also equal to the change in momentum. Change in momentum, that is final minus initial. So impulse, that is equal to change in momentum. Here we have the SI unit in Newton second for the impulse. But impulse is also equal to change in momentum. Change in momentum is also giving some momentum. So for the momentum we have the SI unit, that is kg meter per second. So the Newton second SI unit of impulse, kg meter per second is also the SI unit of impulse. So for impulse you can give both the units, Newton second or kg meter per second. And for momentum also we can give both the unit, kg meter per second or Newton second. Any unit can be given. Right. Now this impulse, it is obtained from the Newton second law. It is obtained from the Newton second law. And for this relation, by taking this relation, that is delta P equal to F into delta T, or we can say it is F into delta T equal to final minus initial momentum. That is change in momentum. From this relation, we can discuss the applications of Newton's second law of motion. There are so many applications of Newton's second law. Applications of a second law of motion. Right? So, and these applications of Newton's second law of motion are basically the reasoning questions. For reasoning questions, this applications can be asked. Okay. So, we can say they are the conceptual questions. The first application is, while you people are playing cricket or playing any kind of ball, mostly in cricket, we are taking the catch of the ball. Suppose a cricket player is going to catch a ball, right? And the ball is in air. It is moving with some velocity. Suppose the ball, its mass is m. And in the beginning, it is moving with some velocity. So its momentum is mu. And this ball is moving towards a player. He is going to catch the ball. Suppose he take the hand at this position. Suppose this is the position of hand. And on reaching the hand, the person, the player, catch the ball and stop at once. So as the ball is reaching the hand and it is stopped finally, so the final momentum, that is equal to zero because it is stopped at this position. When it is stopped, its velocity is zero and its momentum become zero. So here the momentum of the ball is changed. In the initial, we have initial momentum mu, finally we have mv. So the change in momentum, that is final momentum minus initial momentum, that is equal to 0 minus mu and it is minus mu. This is the change in momentum produced in this object. Here, as the ball reaches the hand, just before reaching the hand, it has the momentum mu. On reaching the hand, its momentum becomes zero. So the change in time to change the momentum, in how much time the momentum is changed, that is the delta t. That is delta t. And that delta t, here the person, the player, catch the ball and stop it at once. Immediately he stopped. So we can assume the delta t, it may be 1 second, but definitely it will be less than 1 second. So we are taking the time is 1 second. So in this case, the time interval is 1 second, that is very small. So the change in momentum is taken place as minus mu. To change this much of momentum, the time taken is 1 second, right? For this interval, definitely the ball on reaching the hand exerts some force on the hand. Definitely the ball exerts some force on the hand, right? On the other hand, the same ball, when it is moving with the momentum mu, reaching the hand of the player, right? Now the player is holding the hand at this position. On taking the ball in his hand, he is not stopping at once. What he is doing actually, he is lowering the hand in the downward direction. Finally, he stopped the ball. So at this position, the momentum become zero. So By taking the ball in the hand, while reaching the hand, the ball has momentum mu. It has a momentum mu. So that hand is lowered. It is lowered. To lower the hand from this position, definitely it takes some time. It takes some time, and that time taken is delta t. If we compare the time taken to change the momentum, here also we can calculate the momentum, change in momentum. Final momentum 0 minus initial momentum, this is equal to minus mu. So the change in momentum is minus mu. In the first case also, change in momentum minus mu. In both the cases, change in momentum is same. In both the cases, change in momentum is same. But what is different? In the first case, the delta t is very small. And in the second case, definitely the delta t, that is change in time. Or we can say the time taken to change the momentum, that is somewhat longer than the first case. So here if we take the delta t, or we can say this delta t dash. This delta t dash is obviously it is greater than the first case, right? Okay, so if we apply this concept in this law, here you see the change in momentum in both the cases, stopping the ball at once or stopping the ball by lowering the hand. In both the cases, change in momentum constant. This thing is constant.